amazing being back out here and playing live music for real life people. I don't know about y'all, but I was sick and tired of Zoom. I'm over Zoom. It's great to be back. Y'all getting to write songs for a living and come out here playing for y'all and have y'all singing with us is just an amazing thing. We write a lot of songs, but every now and then you write a song that means so much to you personally. Back in 2015, February 2015, I was sitting down writing songs, and I just lost one of the greatest men of my life I'd ever known, my granddaddy Bill. Granddaddy Bill was a hero who at a young age decided he wanted to fight for our country, and he joined the Air Force. He got stationed all around the country, really all around the world. Eventually, he got stationed down in San Juan, Puerto Rico. While he was there, he was working hard, but he still made sure he had time. Still made sure he had time for some fun. So one night, him and some of the guys in the Air Force decided they wanted to go on a blind date with some Puerto Rican ladies. And it must have gone pretty well, because when he finished up the date, dropped his lady back off at the front door, he looked at her and he said, "Hey, you might not believe me, but one day I'm going to marry you." Lady, she looked back at him square in the eyes and said, "Sir, you are either drunk or you are crazy." She slammed the door in his face. That's my grandma. Boy, she is a little Puerto Rican spitfire. She don't put up with no crap from nobody. Oh, it sounds like the start of a joke. A West Virginian and a Puerto Rican walk into a bar with y'all. They had 56 years of great marriage. They taught me so much of that, man. I'm not sure if I'm the only one, but I'm one of the only country artists down there in Nashville who has a grandma with the name of Paquita Rivera Guadalupe de Francesca McCreery. Man, I love that woman. Love that woman. But y'all, losing Granddaddy Bill is hard. And the way I express my emotions is through songs. So that day I wrote a song, tweeted out that day, it's my favorite song I've ever written. It became my first number one single, and since that, hearing y'all stories about what this song has meant to y'all, how it's helped you through tough times, losing somebody that meant the world to y'all, going through your last football game, your last softball game. Y'all, this next one's my favorite song I've ever written. It's called Five More Minutes. Bye. soon. So much